morning. Still morning. Good morning to everyone who is here, especially our special guest. And today we are going to present about Chinese eating etiquette. Okay, first Pong will start. Pong, please start. Oh, go first. First, do not tap your food when eating. Tapping your food is not only considered rude, but it also indicates poverty in Chinese feng shui. Feng shui, yes. One who taps his food suggests he is constantly in a non-steady state, which is thought to be bad for collecting wealth in feng shui. Feng shui. Feng shui. Okay, I don't know that. Sorry. Okay, the second one.
The second one, do not stick chopsticks straight out in rice. Sticking chopsticks upright in a bowl of rice is a traditional way used by Chinese people to venerate their ancestor. It symbolizes that and is considered bad luck.
Don't tap your bowl with chopstick. Beggar at one time tap their bowl to attract attention, and sometimes in a restaurant, customer do the same thing if they think the service is slow. So tapping your bowl can insult your host.
Okay, number four is don't start eating before your host. In China, guests usually wait until their host take the first bite or invite everyone to start eating. Sometimes the host will begin banquets by first serving the guests of honor and asking everyone else to help themselves. Children need to wait until adult begins to eat.
Do not leave your head under the table. Do not rest your head under the table or out of sight. The same etiquette rule is followed in Russia as bad.
Russia as bad.
For right-handed people who hold chopsticks in their right hand, their left hand either hold down the bowl on the table or pick it up so that it's near your mouth. It is considered rude to leave the left hand on their left.
First one, be careful when asking for seconds. If you are learning Chinese, it can be fun to practice it while enjoying delicious food. But be careful when you ask for second helpings in Chinese, because need rice and what one rice is usually translated to Yao Fan, which also refers to begging for food. Okay.
Number two, eat with your mouth closed. Not just in China, people in other countries get annoyed by the sound of someone eating with his mouth open. In dining etiquette, this is not only unbecoming, but also bothers other people nearby. The same rules apply to drink tea, soup, and various
beverage.
Slurping is considered rude.
Okay. Number three is serve someone else first before you serve for yourself. If you serve for yourself first, it will be considered very rude because and don't know about manners. So when you want others to help, if you want another helping or to refill your food or drinks, offer it to another guest first. If the guest that you offer is in conversation, don't interrupt and just go ahead pour the drink into the cup.
Drinking etiquette. How to propose a toast is important for learning the Chinese table manners. First, there must be something for you for which you'd like to propose a toast.
Second, to propose a toast, it is polite for you to stand up and hold the glass with your two hands.
If you want to offer a toast to the people in attendance, one by one, make sure you know the order according to the
status.
Oh, apa ni?
Video kan? Video kan yang saya
Terbuka
gambar.
Mana nak dipindahkan?
Tekan apa mana?
Oh.
We will end our presentation in here
because of technical errors.
Rasanya boleh jadi kan?
Ganti mungkin.